African Renaissance TV from wherever especially you're watching us from. This is African Sports and I am Mohamed Biba. You are here with me. I have Mohamed M. Sediba and to have the analysis column for the range of games. Today that will be, we'll start with the Gambia versus Guinea game and then from there we transition to the rest of the games for the rest of the groups. And this will be an interesting game because a lot has happened over the last couple of games. But then every little gritty or every little detail will be brought on the discussion table here and then you'll have a chance to join us on this. Well, Sediba, welcome again, and we are back on this hot seat, if you like to call it, especially if you are a lover of the Gambians football team or the Gambians national team. Their game against Guinea has gone a goalless, one nil against the Gambia, and then this doesn't mean Gambia is totally out of the African Cup of Nations as far as the group stages are concerned.
Well, thank you so much, and then, you know, greetings to us. It's great that we are back again here to give analysis on the Gambia versus Guinea game. Of course, you know, the second game of the, you know, the game between Gambia and Guinea, and of course we will also transition into the, you know, to giving pre-match analysis of course the games that we will be having today. So, you know, it's great to be back again.
Well, that is quite great. But let's talk about this. The Gambia has now lost and they are at the bottom of the pool. What does that mean? Is there any hope for going through as one of the best losers comparing the other games that are yet to come?
Well, you know, if you had remembered very well, last time we were here, I have given my prediction that, you know, the Gambia will not make it to the round of 16. But then, of course, it's a huge one. You know, it was an unexpected win, you know, unexpected loss.
Well, if you are a Gambian, you will say unexpected. I said this clearly. Guinea would have seen this coming because they are a team that one should fear because they played a couple of games and then it has been positive.
And then, you know, Guinea, you know, they've produced a whole lot of great players. You know, we've seen Nabikata to have played the last minute of the game yesterday, you know. But then, you know, Gambia played a good game, a little bit good game, even though it's a disappointing performance. You know, the Gambia have zero shot on target for the first time in their Afcon history. You know, they have zero goals for now in their entire campaign for this year. You know, generally,
isn't that surprising considering the caliber of attackers and strikers we have? You come from Minte to Badamosi to Ali, so and you can, these are people that can score anytime and they've been scoring.
But well, generally, I believe, you know, the performance for this campaign is really disappointing. It's really disappointing in the sense that we are not able to score a single goal. We don't even have a single point. So it's quite disappointing, you know, this year's campaign, you know, it's quite disappointing considering the fact that, you know, our maiden appearance, that was the Afcon 2021, which was in Cameroon, you know, we were the element of surprise. But this year we came, you know, but I believe there are a lot of factors that leads to this, you know, starting from the, you know, the experience that the players had to go through, you know, from the earthquake in Mauritania, of course, the, you know, the unpaid bonuses, then the, you know, the incident at the airport and then in the air, you know, while traveling to Yamoussoukro. And it's quite a disappointing performance, but I believe that the players did well.
Well, the AFCON comes every 2 years. This is quite, would this mean, whatever happens for the rest of the group stage for the Gambia? What is the starting position as far as the preparations for the next cup, for the national team, Gambia national team? What should they do next? This one is almost a lost cause, even though
all hopes are not lost. Yes, like the coach said yesterday, the team still have a hope. They still have the chance to qualify.
The coach, you say, they have a mountain to climb. Between Cameroon to at least minimum of 2 goals or 3 to give them the best chances of qualifying seems to me like an impossible task that is ahead of them.
It's a difficult, but like I said, you know, in our first analysis, I told you, you know, it's 11-11. You know, you don't look at the country or the team, but you look at, you know, it's 11 players against 11 players. Of course, Gambia has great players. The Gambia has great players. You know, they have great, you know, great forwards like the likes of Minte, but the most, my favorite, of course, you know, Moussa Barrow. You know, the likes of Ali Sow. They are great players, and then, you know, they have the potential of scoring, you know, more than 2-3 goals in that
well, all hopes are not lost, and especially if you are a Gambian or the a lover or supporter of the Gambian national team. A win against Cameroon with a good goal difference can see Gambia stand a chance of qualifying as one of the best losers of the round. That is a huge hope to hold on to, and then I would like to say best wishes to them, and then best of luck for the rest of the competition if there will be any. But before we transition into the next games that we have to talk about here, we will first take a quick break to acknowledge our sponsors and partners in the name of Gambia.Lions FC, a team that is playing playing a very good attacking football in the second division of the Gambian League. They currently sit seventh, but we'll take a short break after that. The conversation continues from there.
Welcome to the Gambian.Lions Consortium, a pioneering force in the realm of football, committed to illuminating the future of the beautiful game in the Gambia. The Gambian.Lions Football Club, the Sumbala.Lions Football Club, Soundtrack Foundation, and the Football Academy in Faraba stands at the cornerstone of this visionary project. So in a future where the untapped potential of African football players is fully realized, and development opportunities for these athletes are maximized. In the spirit of global reach, the Gambian.Lions Consortium aims to establish a top-tier scouting organization and distinctive Gambian African Football Academy. This visionary project extends beyond trophies, reflecting a commitment to long-term success and talent cultivation. Exciting plans include the initiation of Pro League football in the Gambia and the phased expansion of the cutting-edge football complex. The genesis of the new era in African football begins right here.
Welcome back from that short commercials. If you have just joined us, this is African Sports, and in case you have not subscribed into our channels, and you do subscribe now to get more interesting programs and episodes coming all the way from the African Renaissance TV. And I am Mohamed Bibaji. So with me here on the analysis column is Mohamed M. Setiba. And from the Gambia, we are directing, shifting our attention to Group D. A group that is really going tedious, and then there is a huge challenge in this, because now we have Algeria versus Burkina Faso. Burkina currently leads the group with 3 points, Algeria, Angola are on 1-1 points, and then Mauritania sits on 0 points at the bottom of the table. Mm-hmm. So that game, how would you look at that? What would be your analysis, description of that?
Thank you so much, you know, and then, you know, to the viewers, thank you for, you know, for still being with us. So Algeria, you know, Algeria and Burkina Faso, I think it will be a great game. It will be a, you know, an entertaining one to look out for, you know, considering the fact that, you know, Burkina Faso are on top of the table, and Algeria also will be looking for, you know, for a win so that, you know, they can you know, have the chance to qualify into the round of 16. You know, Algeria have won their last game against Mauritania, you know, 1-0, and then, you know, Algeria were able to draw, you know, to share points with Angola, you know, in their first game. So I believe, you know, this game it will be an entertaining one, and of course, you know, and you know, a difficult one for both the teams. You know, I'm looking up to, you know, a very challenging game between the two teams.
Well, it's a group that is not yet decided. Even the top spot is not yet decided, because today the game can go against Burkina. If that happens, they will all be a leader would be on top of the group with 4 points. If Burkina should win, that means they will also go on to have 6 points that can give them at least a certainty of qualifications, if not the first. But then it's not all lost. Algeria have one of the best attacking potent in Africa, and then their style of play is that attacking style, which is really marvelous to watch. So who would you fancy going through today with a win?
I think the Burkina Faso will stand firm to ensure that, you know, they protect their last win, you know, against Mauritania. I believe, you know, they will do all this, but you know, like you mentioned, Algeria has a very good attacking team. You know, their team is a great team. They have you know, a huge number of international players that are playing in the other parts of the world, you know, and then they are doing great in their various clubs. So I believe, you know, it's a win, it's a challenge for both teams. You know, they will both be, you know, fighting to, you know, to win in that game so that they can sit on top of the table and then, you know, stand a chance of qualifying into the round of 16.
Well, 1 point is a good start for them. I mean, you have someone like Riyad Mahrez. How do you rate him? Because if looked at the performances of the likes of Sadio Mane, the likes of Mohamed Salah or Mohamed Kudus of Ghana, Mane, Mahrez rather is one of those big names that we can look out for. How would you rate him, his play in this competition generally?
Well, Mahrez is a great player. Mahrez at club level, he has been doing great. And of course, you know, at country's level, you know, we have seen last Afcon, he have done, you know, wonders for, you know, Algeria and even their qualifiers. So I believe, you know, he will also be willing to fight, his counterparts like Sadio Mane and all that to be able to, you know, to qualify up to the final and of course lifting the trophy. He will be, you know, working great for that, I think.
Well, the pool does not stop there. We have the likes of Angola and then Mauritania, who would also believe that the fight is still not lost. And then this would be a pool that is going to be a difficult one, because having Algeria and Mauritania are more like teams that have equal the same way of playing football. Mm-hmm. And then Burkina has that strength in terms of physique. But then all in all, it would be a good game for me to say. So, well, let's go into your predictions for the top two to finish out of this group. Before you come to this, I know you did this for the Gambia and it has, for now, Gambia is at a standstill, but then let's go with this.
I believe Algeria has an upper hand right now because they have a win. You know, so a draw today will have them, 4 points, and a win will have them at 6 points. So, you know, as at now, I think Algeria, I will go in for Algeria and of course, Mauritania. You know, it might be awkward or weird because Mauritania lose their first game.
Yes, and you know, Mauritania will be sitting
at the foot of the table. But I believe, you know, they have potential of coming back, you know, with a win today, and then, you know, and also a possible win in their final game to qualify into the rounds.
Well, that is a brave assumption or a brave prediction you're having over there.
Because, you know, looking at their game against Burkina Faso, they played a wonderful football. You know, they were able to, you know, to hold ball, and of course, you know they play really great. They have a few shot on targets that were very, you know, very, very great. You know, they have the potential of course winning even Burkina Faso, Algeria, and all the teams that are involved in the group.
Well, that is why. So we are going to take it for your word. It is Burkina Faso and then Algeria playing here. So all the best to the teams and whatever that holds it for them. Well, yeah, so we've shift our focus from Algeria then to Mauritania and then Angola. They are at the third and then the fourth respectively in the group. And so this would be like, it's not a death rubber stamp because each of these teams here could have the potential of qualifying with a win here today. So what will you rate their game? Burkina Faso, Mauritania rather, are at the bottom and you have seen them going through the group. So
yes.
How would you say that? Why would you say that rather?
Well, Mauritania, like I said earlier, they are playing a very good game. You know, since, you know, at the last Afcon, they played a very wonderful game. They had a very good campaign last Afcon. You know, and then through the qualifiers, they win, you know, most of their games. You know, with a pace of good goals that they score. And then, you know, today's the game, you know, in this Afcon 2, you know, their last game against Burkina Faso, you know, they were able to, you know, to square at least, you know, a little bit. You know, Burkina Faso has a little bit of ball possession ahead of them, you know, but they were able to hold the ball, and then, you know, they were also able to, you know, to create a few chances, you know, and they have a very good goalkeeper. You know, we can see, you know throughout the social media, their goalkeeper, that you know, the tall one, and then he is good both on top and also, you know, at the other sides too. He's a very good goalkeeper. But then, you know all in all, Algeria, Mauritania and Angola, you know, they are both great teams. You know, they are both good teams, and then they also played. Both Angola and Mauritania, you know, are playing, you know, slightly similar tactics. You know, they are both, you know, in the northern part of Africa. You know, we've seen, you know, Algeria played similar tactics with Mauritania. You know, both in the last Afcon, in the qualifiers, and of course in the recent Afcon that we are going to. So, but then, you know, all in all, I believe, you know, the game will be an entertaining one. It will be a great one, actually.
Well, all the best to the rest of the teams in that group, Algeria, Mauritania, or Burkina, whoever stands as the qualifiers for the top two teams to qualify, would be a great course for them. But I want us to transition or to move our attention to Group E. It's one of the toughest groups because we have here Mali against Tunisia today, and then that would be an interesting game. So that's the game we are looking at. But in the rest of the group, we have Namibia and then South Africa. These are huge nations, huge footballing nations. Especially in the African Cup of Nations, and then they are here to do a good job. But then if you have a look at this, Mali, Tunisia. Mali currently sits on top of the group, and then Tunisia is at the third position. But then all hopes are not lost because this is just a single game, and then Mali is with a win that is 3 points. whilst Tunisia and then South Africa are with 0 points. But then Mali and Tunisia, how do you see that game? That would be a difficult game.
Yes, it would be a difficult game. You know, the northern parts of Africa, you know, they play very good football. You know, all in all, you know, especially when they play against West African countries.
Well, it's always a tough one. The competition is like physical football against possession football.
And then, you know, Mali also have been very good. You know, Mali, you know, last Afcon, I can remember they were a group in the same group with the Gambia. You know, even though the Gambia were able to manage a point, to have a point with them in the last Afcon. But then, you know, all in all, Mali is a great team. They are doing, they're having a, you know, very physical team. Their team are, of course, you know, always very physical. But this year we've seen a trend that is, you know, having an, you know, a younger, much younger teams, you know, in both African teams. You know, we've talked about the Senegalese all. But then Mali also have a young team. And then they also have the potential of winning Tunisia. But notwithstanding, Tunisia is a very good team too. They played, you know, very good.
Well, Tunisia has a very good record in the Afcon. In fact, even at the world stage, they play like Tunis along with Algeria and other African countries that have been doing wonders in the world stage had a good one. Mm-hmm. But I want to look at this because Namibia has came out as a surprise target. I mean, in this group, at the initial predictions, if you look at this, Namibia was looked at as a team that would be at the bottom. But now they sit at second with 3 points. The same points with Mali. South Africa currently sits on 0 points. So with this group, I want it to be a fast one. What would be your predictions for the top two teams to qualify? Given that Mali is currently the leader with 3 points alongside with Namibia, but then Tunisia and South Africa, who else?
Well, I will give it to, you know, Mali and Namibia, considering the fact that Mali is playing Tunisia today and then Namibia is playing South Africa. So you know, Namibia wouldn't want, you know, to lose the opportunity, you know, from being an element of surprise to the world, and then also, you know, to going to lose against South Africa. I believe, you know, they will try to stick onto their winning ways. You know, that is to win South Africa and maintain their position, or either to go on top or to maintain their position. Mali too, I believe they will not also want to, you know, to lose their winning ways to going back to a draw or a win. So I will give it to Namibia. Mali and Namibia.
Well, that is quite amazing. Like you've said in the previous analysis here, this AFCON is promising goals, and we've been seeing goals all along. Well, even though there has been a goal draft for the Gambia, but the rest of the teams in the competition have been scoring goals in and out. But we will take the end of this analysis here, and then we look up to the rest of the games that are coming ahead. It has been a great having you here. With your predictions, I will always point you to this producer when you come back next year, whatever two teams that we've identified in all these groups that we've discussed today, they are qualifiers, and all the fans will be there to hold you to account to this in case it comes out.
It's a prediction.
Well, viewers, this is all we have for you from African Sports, coming away from the African Renaissance TV with me, Mohamed B. Baji, and with my co-host here, Mr. Mohamed M. Sediba, who also turns out to be a special analyst for this this AFCON here, especially. And then we are hopeful this is going to continue. It will not just stop on this AFCON. I will have you here to analyze some other games in other parts of the world where all African talents can be produced or are playing that threat currently.
With a special focus on, of course, the Division Leagues of the Gambia.
Well, yes, we are going to have focus on the Division League of the Gambia. I'm talking of the Division League, especially only Division 2, that is where our sponsors and partners, the Gambian Dutch Lions, are flying the roof, where they are currently 6th on the league, and that is an impressive feat. Scoring goals and here and there, one of the best attacking teams in the league currently, and we are hopeful that they are going to go far. And the Gambian football is also growing at a very nice pace. But then for the rest of the competitions, to the rest of the teams and all the fanfare that is out there, we are wishing all the teams best of luck. And to our able cameraman, Mr. Mohamed B, who is also doing a very good job, and the technical team, we are always grateful for the time, and then anyone that is watching us from any part of the world, this has been an amazing feeling that you've been on this journey with us. Until we come your way with more interesting programs and episodes from the African Renaissance TV and other coverages that we have for you from here, this is all that we have for you.